Okay, so in today's video, we're going to take a quick look at angles on a straight line. So to be able to solve these questions today, we need to understand one of our important angle rules, and that is that angles on a straight line will always add up to 180 degrees. So now let's use that to solve some of these questions. So for this first example, we need to work out the size of the angle marked x. So using our angle rule, we know that angles on a straight line will always add up to 180. So if there's two angles there of 127 and x will add up to 180, all we have to do to figure out what x is take that 127 away. So we're going to do 180, take away that 127, and that's going to leave us with 53. So the size of the angle marked x would be 53 degrees. And that would be my answer to that one. And again, we can see that's true because if we do the opposite, if we do that 127, add on the 53, that would get us back to our 180. Okay, moving on, we want to work out the size of angle marked x again. So again, using our angle rule, we know when we add all these angles together, we should get 180. So what we're going to do in this scenario is actually add the angles that we've been given. So we're going to add together our 31 and our 47. Well, if we do that, we get 78. So we know the sum of the angles that we've been given add up to 78, and all we have left is that angle x. So because they should all add up to 180, we're simply going to do 180, take away the 78, and that's going to leave us with 102. So the size of the angle x for this one would be 102 degrees. Okay, for this next one again, we're figuring out the size of the angle marked x. We've now got four angles. So moving left to right, we've got a right angle. We've then got 33. We've then got our missing angle x. And then we have 31. So we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to add together the angles that we know the size of. So starting on the left, we've got a right angle. So we know a right angle is 90 degrees. So we're going to take 90. We're going to add on our 33. We've then got our x, which we're going to leave for in a minute. And then we're going to add on this final 31. So if I now add all these numbers together, I get 154. So if the sum of the three angles is 154, the only one that's left over is our x. Then because we know they should all add up to 180, we're simply going to do 180, take away this 154, and that's going to leave us with 26. So our missing angle x here would be 26 degrees. Okay, and for this very last question, again, we're figuring out the size of the angle marked x, but this time we have two of them. So what I'm actually going to do for this one is I'm going to collect the like terms because we're adding all these angles together and they should add up to 180 degrees. So I'm going to start with the x's. So I've got an x here and another x here. So if I add them together, that should give me 2x. And then in terms of the angles we were given, we've got 52 degrees and 84 degrees. Well, if I add them 2 degrees together, I actually get 136. So as an expression, the angles on this straight line would add up to 2x plus 136, because all we've done is collect the like terms. But we can now turn this expression into an equation because we know all of these angles added together, because they're on a straight line, would equal 180 degrees. So we've now got an equation. So now we want to solve it. It's very similar to what we've done before. We take away the value that we've already figured out. So rearranging this equation, we can see we've got 2x plus 136 is equal to 180. So we're going to balance the equation. I'm going to take 136 away from this side, and I'm going to do exactly the same on the other side. Well, if I do this here, I'm now left with 2x on the left-hand side is equal to 180 take away 136 leaves us with 44. So now we're left with 2x, which is what both of these angles add up to together. So now we need to figure out what each individual x would be. So to do that, I'm going to do the opposite. Because I've got 2 times x here, I'm simply going to do the opposite. So I'm going to divide this left-hand side by 2, which means I'm going to do exactly the same on the right-hand side. So 2x divided by 2 would give us x, and then on the right, 44 divided by 2 would give us 22. So both of these angles, which are marked x, would be 22 degrees. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.